Hello and welcome to the show. We are here today on BeamNG Drive, taking some more vehicles around the proving ground circuit and driving them until they fall apart and can't go any further, pretty much. Now, the first vehicle I have today, I don't actually know what mod this comes from. I thought I'd cleared my game out at one point, and whatever mod this is from was hanging around. It's a CrownVic banger racer, essentially. So we're talking like full-on banger spec vehicle here. It's got peculiar tires going on. I mean, it's got big heavy-duty roll cage in the vehicle. Kind of curious to see how long it's going to survive around this track, because it's very, very different to everything else that has gone around before. It is also unbelievably noisy. It's stupendously loud, this car. But, you know, that's that. Oh, it's got plenty of speed for the jump. Maybe a little too much speed for the jump on the first time around. And then the actual, it's quite oversteery as well. The wheels and tyres are sort of always weirdly small on this. I imagine maybe better traction on the dirt? We'll have to wait and see how it goes. Yeah, there was almost a bit too much speed because it kind of landed the first jump hitting the up ramp, if you like, for the second jump. But there we go. We are across. The fact is, though, that sort of crash could well have killed cars, I feel. And this has taken it in its stride. It's not actually even bent the steering. That's the level of strength we're talking about in this car. It has bent the steering a little bit. Nothing crazy, though. That's good news. And that's a seriously tough vehicle. Across the Toblerones we go. Now, while it is a tough vehicle, suspension is relatively soft without being springy by the looks of it, which is good. As we go through the spinners, making almost got the roll cage bar caught there. But yeah, the suspension on this does seem quite good in that it is absorbing bumps, but unlike some of like the rally cars, some of the off-road vehicles as well, the suspension kind of like bounces the vehicle back up into the air, which is not at all what you want. So, a little bit uncomfortable across there. Big hit on the ground. The front corner, I think the front corner where it hit hard last time is... Has that rear axle shifted ever so slightly? I just noticed the wheel is poking out on the left-hand side slightly. And it's not. But it's definitely not on the right-hand side. It's, I think, the actual whole rear axle. Maybe it was doing it from the get-go and I just didn't notice. That is possible. Well, but it does look like the rear axle may have shifted slightly in the car. We bounce around across there. I don't actually know what suspension. I've got lots of understeer going on through that corner, which is not quite what we want. The rear axle, it's still slightly poking out to the left-hand side of the car. Ooh, bounce again. Yeah, it doesn't really have much grip of anywhere, to be honest with you. It doesn't have... It's got lots of understeer and quite a lot of oversteer. The front end is starting... You can see the front end, the end of the bonnet is starting to bend upwards after these sort of repeated batterings. Now, one of the issues I might have with this car, if it's very oversteer, it starts taking damage. That's not the angle we wanted to be flying through the air at. If it is already naturally oversteer, we start taking damage, is basically spinning it when we're approaching jumps, and that gives you horrible landings like that. We have got it, gathered it all back up. I mean, the front of the bonnet is now quite high. My concern is the chassis starts dragging on. They've definitely got the rear axle shifting. That's further than it was before. Yeah, okay, we've got rear axle issues going on. It's not come loose like we saw from the Moonhawk or we have seen from the Regency in the past. Oh, what did that hit? Nothing good, I would expect. Don't know if that hit chassis rail or something. Oh dear. Now, as this rear axle shifts, I don't know how far it can shift. It's definitely moved from where it was. It's now even more pronounced. It's not crazy, but it is definitely getting there. Oh god, no steering at all. Yeah, the more that moves, the worse handling the car is going to get. It's just going to make it handle weird and inconsistent, which is not really what you need. Thankfully, the front end, despite actually taking considerable damage to that front end, is not actually affected by steering on the most part in any ways. That is good news for the car. Steering damage is... steering damage hasn't been as big a problem around here as I perhaps expected to see from vehicles. Really, the steering damage has put a couple of vehicles out, that's for sure, but... Oh, it's not put that many out, has that? Oh god, please get stopped. I was wondering if that pushed the wheel even further across. I don't think so. Yeah, steering damage, you know, pinging off wheels, losing wheels is always a bad thing. This track is more of a chassis killer, to be honest with you. This is more bending chassis to the point where drive shafts snap. Some other things go along the way, of course, before that. But yeah, that is the primary cause of death, if you like, around here. Ooh, that's fine. Landed a bit heavy on one side. Didn't roll over though. We don't see too many rollovers around this track. The wheel maybe more to the left now. It's difficult to tell what's the axle now shifting and what's the bodywork being bent, so that it's also, I definitely think that is now much more to the left than it was beforehand. That's a weird issue it's got going on. It's not affecting the handling too much. This is you know, the important thing really. It might look stupid, and in reality it might be horrifically bad for the car and all that, but it's actually not worth say that. Oh. Okay, it is affecting the handling just in inconsistent ways. It's like sometimes you're driving along and the car decides, you know what, I want to be really sideways now, and you're not going to have any control over it. I said about not too many rollovers. That is a big tumble for the car. It's not actually done very much. I say that. No, maybe it has done more to the chassis than I realised. It's a big rollover. I'm worried. I mean, I'm looking at where the chassis is on the floor. I'm worried about some of the load, some of the, like the checkerboard and those sort of areas. It might actually just try and tear the chassis off, or tear the underside of the car apart. We have seen that be a problem for vehicles in the past. Is this got enough clearance? It still does. Just doesn't feel great. Definitely is catching, but it's still going. Oh, it's a tough car this. Now, is the rear axle still? I mean, I presume the rear axle still shifted, but the whole bodywork's got twisted because it landed on the fence. So I don't know how much twisted that is anymore. Oh. No, it's still definitely not happy. It's not come free yet, but it is bouncing around a fair bit. Alright, into the spinners we go. Ooh! Ooh! I'm glad we spun the car there. It, as I say, it's got oversteer issues, but they're now exacerbated by that rear axle being all sorts of wonky. It just makes it a lot more difficult to keep control of the car. Or it's more than a surprise, it's the sudden kick of oversteer, or, you know, the steering movement suddenly done something you don't expect. Like here, for example, I'm trying to get the car, oh god, for the jump set up. Don't land so hard on that wheel. That front wheel is taking an absolute battering and it's still going. Amazing. Front wheel is okay. That's the sort of hit that tears wheels off. That's the sort of landing that breaks cars, really, when you land really heavily on the front wheels. But this is not real. Oh, come on. It doesn't turn. It really struggles with the steering sometimes. I mean, that just means we've got no speed coming off over that ledge. Not that that's actually doing too much to the vehicle. To be honest with you, it's a tough old car, this, so far. These jumps are surprisingly damaging to some vehicles. I feel like they're just not doing anything to this car. It's really the big... I'd say it's really the big jumps. It's the start-finish line jump, I think, is one of the nastiest ones for this particular vehicle. The shafted jump is not actually causing too much issues. Oh, we're out of control a little bit coming down here. Don't go towards the fence, for Christ's sake. I don't know why I wanted to twist that way. If anything, I was aiming the car the other direction. I mean, we're across there. Okay, well, we're still going. It's still somehow making progress around this course. That's not really what I want. It's just landing flat on the nose. The radiator is very well protected in this car. I will say, like, distance-wise, it's not gone... I mean, it's doing okay at the moment, but it's a long way from the top. It's taking its sweet time to get there. I think it's been spun around quite a lot and all over the place, really. Most cars would be dead by this level of damage, but the level of damage this thing has got is quite a lot, shall we say. But it is still going. Oh, I'm really worried about the chassis catching somewhere, but it is across still. If anything, I wonder why some of the damage might have bent it back into some sort of shape. I feel like it was running lower last lap around. I could be wrong on this. Oh god, understeer, understeer, understeer. Just chronic understeer from the car around some of these corners. Oh, no, still good. I mean, I think we might have got some collapsed suspension going on somewhere, but it's nothing too bad. Oh, clocked the door through there, but that's not... I mean, that's a minor bop on the spinners. Okay, calm. Let us run towards... We've got a slight tweak on the steering now. Yeah, it's pulling to the left ever so slightly, which is never what you want. Oh, I didn't correct that enough. Thankfully, it got... It's got so lucky with that landing. That could have been all sorts of catastrophic. But no, the car is absolutely fine. on this one. Well, I say that when you look at the state of it. It's not absolutely fine, but the landing of the jump didn't really do any additional damage to the vehicle. Right, can I try and... I've got to be, like, really slow on the way into this corner, because it just doesn't turn. The car's just... is nothing. Fall off the edge. Oh. Well, that put the axle back into place. Who knew? What was the biggest concern for this car? That if... it, oh, no, it slid out again. Okay, well, ignore that slightly. It briefly put the axle back into place. Oh, well, it was worth a try, crashing to fix it and everything. You never know, sometimes it does happen. Rare, but sometimes. This time we're over that jump nicely. This jump here is the scary one, really. I just don't know what the car's going to do. Okay, that time flew quite nice and level. Can we get your car all under control? We can get a mile of understeer through there that I wasn't quite expecting. And across the next jump, we go. Heavy impact on the floor. I actually just realised I was steering in the air, which you really shouldn't do, because it lands on the front wheel quite heavily. I was like, it was not quite a panic, but it was the almost like I must carry on steering the car to try and right it, even though there's nothing I can do because it's in the air, and this is Beam, not GTA 5. Just that instinct. Oh, don't we want to slide across those checkerboards? That is asking for damage. I don't know how this thing's still going. It's, aside from being quite... I think it's been understeery basically from the get-go. It's understeery followed by massive oversteer like that. That is a perfect demonstration of how this car drives. That's not really changed. It's just the occasional it lets go for... I say for no good reason, but it lets go because of the rear... or the axle being in a weird place. I think it might let go if the axle like shifts about slightly. So you just get sort of weird, inconsistent traction and grip, etc. Which makes sense. It's definitely not in a healthy place anymore, this car. Alright, can we get this vehicle a bit straighter for the jump up here? That's okay. That's hit again. It hits the ground really hard there, which is not really doing anything. The wheel is almost all the way to the left now. Not really hindering its progress too much, astonishingly. It would be funny if that axle comes off. It always is funny when you have the rear axles fall apart. I mean, the front's been bent up, but it's been bent up since lap one. It's not... Oh, dear. Oh, dear. Okay, well, we'll land in the mud. Again, it's not really done anything worse. The engine's... I mean, how anything's still quite connected in there, I don't know, because that front is so buckled, but it is still working. It's still got life. When the radiator is not gone, this is not going to be timed out from an overheating. At least if it is, I'd be amazed by that, because, well, it might be an overheating in the end that gets it, but the radiator is looking pretty well protected so far. Nothing's really shown any signs of breaking that radiator here. So yeah, we'll have to wait and see really what happens on this. Oh god, car's wandering. Oh, that's another horrific hit on the front. Yeah, it just wanders a little bit down the straight, but oh, well, it hits something quite hard through there. That's a very, very big flight. Oh, don't go into the... necessarily go into the trees. We do still have steering, because that doesn't look right on that front wheel. Is it any worse than it was? The front wheel, it looks like some part of that has come off. Definitely something's not right with that front. Oh yeah, it looks like it's maybe lost like a bottom suspension arm or something like that. It's connected by the tie rod, but... that's it. That's all that's holding that on. Okay. Well, I don't know if it's going to hold together across these, unfortunately. It's still going. That is a stubborn wheel. Could we see a vehicle to take the top spot here? Could it do it? I mean, it's... it might have got to its point now where it's done something that it's just going to make... because it hasn't really taken much damage for a while. That damage to the wheel might be the thing that now makes it a lot less healthy and now take further damage. It doesn't steer very well through the spin, as we have been clocked a couple of times. Thankfully, the car is very strong. I mean, it is good news for the car there, is that despite the fact it wouldn't really turn properly through that section, it's still got the strength, it's still got the resolve, if you will, to survive that. If we land on that front wheel again, though, will it survive the hit? Oh, somehow, yes, is the answer. We landed really heavily on the front, and it's still going along. I mean, it's... if it gets to this point next lap, it's... going to be getting very, very close. It's going to be getting very, very close. It's 11 point something miles, although the distance indicator is not always 100% accurate on these vehicles. This far is still ridiculously good going. All the concerns now are focused on that front right wheel. It is the wheel that tends to take the punishment around this circuit. It is the one, because it's the one that gets hit from the jumps like this. Oh, it's the one that gets folded under, generally speaking. And it's definitely weakened from where it was last lap. It's like the only thing that has got weaker since, well, from about lap 3 onwards, it stayed fairly consistent in terms of what was working on the car and what isn't working on the car. The steering is not in a great way, but we are across. We're across there, but it just, I couldn't get it back together again. That has punctured the radiator. The bigger concern is, what other damage has that done? Just bounced around on the landing of that jump. Can I actually pull? I mean, we have got to try and pull the car off the railings. I think it actually is wedged. Now, if the car is crash welded in, there is only so much that we can do, and it might end up breaking the car more in trying to rescue the car. Oh, yeah, the wheel is gone. The wheel is gone, but the car still drives. Holy crap. It still lives. It is still going. Nothing is going to stop this bloody car by the looks of it. I'd be worried about hitting the checkerboards, maybe. I don't know what that's going to hit and what that's going to do damage-wise. Oh, doesn't really turn that way all so well. It might actually struggle in the spinners. It really depends on if the wheel will play nicely here. Come on. Okay, we're across the checkerboards. Now, this is going to be a tough corner for the car. We'll try and tip it in with a little bit of handbrake going on. It's through. If the wheel falls underneath the car while it's in the spinners, that's going to be game over. If it doesn't, we might be okay. Pretty much. That's the state we're in here. This is probably the worst condition car I've had try to take on the spinners. We can turn to the left well. It's trying to get out the other side. Oh, it's not so good at. It's got hit, and it's been hit very hard by them. The axle, well, I don't even know if the axle's been shifted the other way or the body's been shifted the other way. The engine is starved of oil. We might have had the similar thing we had to the hopper, where the oil pan gets wrecked. Something's got wrecked in that. I think maybe it was, it might have the engine from a hole, I don't know. Something has gone on in that the spinner, well, it is the first death by a spinner. That is the first death blow by spinner. Something went in the engine. I guess it was the oil loss, something like that has happened. That is one tough car though. That is one hell of a tough car. I have to give it credit on that one. That just kept going and going and going, despite the rear axle moving around. Even with the wheel lost, it didn't seem to care. It survived 3 hits from the spinner, aside from the engine. Up next, we have got the Bagel. This is the Doyle Bagel. It's basically a classic, sort of decent-sized European car that is going to take on our destruction circuit. And it has quite a lot to live up to, shall we say, following the last outing. That's CrownVic Banger Racer did put on a hell of a show. Oh, God, this is very wibbly-wobbly and... okay. It's fine. It's got a lot of body roll going on. I guess that kind of makes sense in some ways. And God, I'm looking at the rear axle again. It's flapping around all over the place already. Yeah, lots of body roll going on. Concerns immediately for this car are the steering. It is already pulling very badly to one side. Not particularly what I wanted. And we're going to go for a spin. Radiator isn't damaged, though. It's always a concern when the radiator gets damaged within about half a lap. You know, your car's in trouble. This one has at least survived a few obstacles without that radiator going. It's definitely got some serious steering damage already. Not going to be so happy across Toblerones. Not the worst we've ever had across there, though. The spinners, well, we've already seen them claim their first their first victim, really. We are through no problems at all with this car. Maybe it's a little slow on the way. I've got to be a little careful with this car. I'm just not trusting the steering at the moment. Good God, it's almost this hopping through that corner. That is not what we need at all. I am worried about this jump here. Quite worried about this jump because the car's pulling so much. In fact, through there, we see it twisting on takeoff. Oh, that's actually really nicely done. Oh, okay, it hit hard at the front, and I think it's collapsed all the front suspension on lap one. Yep, it has by the looks of it. But it didn't snap the drive shaft. We didn't bust the radiator. you know, the little victories. The little victories in this. The rear axle is still, or the rear wheels, it looks like they're flapping around. It's really weird what they've got going on there. They have got something. There's an Eve meowing in the background a lot. It's not your dinner time. You've got ages to go until it's your dinner time, you greedy kitten. Well, medium cat, really. Ooh, rear left, problems. Problems for rear left, big problems for rear left. What's gone on there? What has gone on with the rear left? It's completely collapsed. Everything's collapsed on that side. You see, I always meant this to have, like, the sort of solid axle at the back, but it might have, well, that'd be surprisingly modern suspension, but it looks like it might have independent, because the left's completely collapsed, the right's fine. It's buckled a little bit, but yeah, that must be individual corners, because that is completely gone on the rear left. It's now making driving very difficult for this car. The handling is completely shot to pieces. It constantly wants to turn left. I was worried about that when I saw the wheels so broken. When I saw that down there, I was really, really worried about a drive shaft going. Turns out I was right to be worried about that. I think three out of the four corners had the suspension collapse by the looks of it. Both front and the rear left have gone. The rear right is okay. It is still rolling at the moment. It was not as long-lived as the CrownVic. It was at least spectacular. Entertaining silly failure on this one. Yeah, suspension collapse leading to the drive shaft going. It was kind of a good car, but just, yeah, the suspension could not deal with the damage with the forces that was going on, and yeah, that was it for the drive shaft. And finally, we go back to an American vehicle, a really classic American vehicle, the Burnside. This is the Burnside special custom, it's the V8 with a supercharger, basically, and a manual gearbox, which is kind of important in some ways for these cars. This is going to be quite quick. One thing I've got to be very careful is not to over rev the engine. With these classic cars, it's quite easy to do, especially the supercharged classic V8. Oh, clonk. Now, the Burnside is an interesting one. Theoretically speaking, this can actually be quite good around here. It can be pretty strong. We have seen it do well in the past. It has that Wobblematic suspension that is, I say, so important, but it has suspension that will often absorb a lot of impacts. It's very difficult to kill that suspension. It is a little bit uncontrollable by virtue of the amount of power. You can either have a really slow vehicle, it's a bit boring, or you have a really fast vehicle, which is a bit terrifying, really. So we are going to be steering it from the rear sometimes around here. It's going to be a lot of care with the throttle. We'll probably have to brake for the, or certainly lift off for the big jump, the shafted jump. I'm not sure how quick it's going to get, but if you're too fast over that jump, okay, I overdrove it on the way in there and I locked the brakes up, trying to get it stopped, and just slid forward. Now, the good news, yeah, jeez, this thing can shift. The good news is that is mostly just visual damage. Basically, if you're going about 75, 78 miles an hour, you start getting to the point where you don't, you will not quite clear the fence, but you will not be able to slow down in time for the fence. So, well, yes, all of the vehicles have to be driven hard around here. They can't just be, minimum speed required to get it around. There also comes a point where you can't be flat out with all the vehicles because you will legitimately clear parts of the circuit. So, yeah, it does get a little bit of a lift down there. I mean, I can't actually go that fast around here on the dirt because I don't have any traction to do anything. We haven't got the grip to be able to put the power down because there is so much power in it. I don't know how much, but there is a lot. Judging by the speed that the thing is getting up to, oh, that clonked out the radiator. That's a concern. I mean, in some ways I'd be surprised if it was overheating that killed it, to be honest. I feel like there's probably something that's going to give it grief before then, judging by how buckled it is already. We're not just talking about the roof line here. As you know how that happened, but I'm talking about the chassis from the landing of these jumps. You see, it's actually not. Oh God, don't turn that way. We've already had one car in the bridge. Okay, we're going to have to again go to the node grabber. We're going to have to try and grab the cart and pull it out of here. Now, this is not so easy. Oh, okay, not done as much damage as the... or not got as wedged as the Crown Vic. It's done quite a lot of damage to the front end, though. If the radiator wasn't gone already, it would have been there. Right, here we go. Across the bumps we head. It's not doing pleasant things for the car. It's again been just spun around on the takeoff. Do I still have enough steering to carry out? I don't really know if it did much damage there. Because it's when they're landing sideways, thankfully it's skidding down the road rather than rolling over. And that is very helpful for any vehicle. But pretty much you'd rather it skid than roll. Rolling you'd risk... well, you'd rather it skid... ooh, that's bad. Bad news. If we're that low, we're catching in the rocks. Checkerboard is going to be a problem. Rolling at least dissipates some energy over coming to a complete halt, but you do run the risk of snapping off wheels and stuff if it's rolling. Whereas at least if it skids along on its roof, for example, or on its side, you're not actually really damaging anything unless it hits... oh god, it's a mile of understeer. Unless it hits something like the checkerboard, for example, if you're going sideways and then you hit an obstacle, that will potentially rip off wheels. Thankfully not got that down the start finish straight particularly. Oh, all right. Okay, really careful of the throttle needed there. That's dangerous. It's just you get on the throttle and it just kicks sideways. I've got to be so delicate with the car. And of course, it's going to get worse. The more damage this car has, the more difficult that's going to be to balance. Like here, in fact, here, oh, piston rings are taken. A whack. Here it's actually starting to get really difficult to keep control of the vehicle by virtue of... god, on the dirt, I've got no traction. I think maybe the steering is not quite 100%. Funnily enough, when you look at the state of the car, the steering may not be 100% in this. Something's definitely not right. I mean, there's so many bits of bodywork in the way, I can barely see what is buckled up there. Oh, come on. Okay, we're down again. I don't know. Pretty much. It's missing bits of car everywhere. It is quite poorly. It is quite poorly, but it's still going. It's still carrying on. Oh, there's a lot of camber on the front left. That's something that we do have that will not be helping with handling issues. A lot of camber. That's definitely got worse. Head gaskets on the way out. Now, what might we see with this? It may overheat before it even gets back to the... Oh, thank you, car. May overheat before it gets to the shallow grave. Very difficult to know. We're across the speed bumps there, no problem. Coolant is overheating. Hits the ground very, very hard through there. The back of the car is all sorts of unhealthy going on. Now, the thing is, the engine is now damaged, regardless of whether we cool it down or not. The engine is very, very poorly anyway. So even if we get the temperature down a little bit... come on, get out of there. There's still all of the damage. Something else has gone wrong with the car. Something's gone very wrong with the car. the engine's gone. I don't know what else went wrong with the car. I think something was scraping on the floor. The engine's locked up. Yeah, the minimal amount of cooling. I think something broke in the steering by the end of it. Something was very, very... again. Something was very poorly with that car by the end. Funnily enough, wasn't having a good time. Another vehicle collected by the spinners. A small lock of the brakes actually got me in trouble. I think all the shock absorbers and all the suspension was basically collapsed by the end of it. Maybe the front right looks like it might be okay. I think the rest of it's long gone. I mean, not the longest lived vehicle, but it did put on a spectacular show of falling apart. So, we are on to the leaderboard, and the CrownVic would go... into second place. It was running very, very well indeed. And, I mean, even the hit from the spinner had it not... I think it is, it knocks the oil pan off. Not that it actually comes up with any information, but certainly something happened with the oil in that car. I think it all escaped, pretty much. And the engine seized up. Had that not happened, I think it may have lived long enough. You never know. It may have lived long enough to go to the top spot. However, was not to be an impressive run, nevertheless, from that car. Now, we have to go a little bit further down. Still, it's not talking too bad to find that Burnside, 16th place with that 3.8 miles. It's a fairly close area of the table. Again, the distance indicator is not always 100% accurate, to do with like wheel spin and all of that sort of thing. But yeah, it's a decent showing. In the end, some heavy suspension damage led to, I mean, the car scraping on the floor. I really thought we were going to lose a drive shaft from it scraping on the floor, but nope, the engine got too hot. And that would explode it. And finally, we have the Beagle. I think I called it the Bagel by accident at some point. Don't mind me, I can't read sometimes. But yes, the Beagle will go into 27th place. The suspension on that car just collapsed. Three out of four corners were basically gone by the end of the first lap. And that's a problem, really, for the car. Not at all surprised. I mean, if the drive shaft hadn't gone on that particular bump, I have a suspicion it would have gone either on the jumps or through the water or the, you know, next bit. It was never going to last long with that suspension gone. But there we go. An entertaining episode. There, of course, shall be a link to all the mods I have used in the description if you want to download them and have a go with them yourself. But that's going to be it from me. Thank you all very much for watching. And until next time, a goodbye.